Hello students, I am Sunny sir from Mohadi English School. This video is for students of class 3, subject grammar. Our today's thought: it is easy to stand in the crowd, but it takes courage to stand alone, written by Mahatma Gandhi. So in this thought, it is a very deep meaning it has, that if you are standing with everyone, if you are standing in a group where there are so many people by your side, then it is very easy. But when you are standing alone, means when no one is there with you, you are only one standing against the whole group, then it is difficult. So it takes courage. It is very difficult to do it, but you must do it when you are right. These are the general instructions that I give you every day that you all have to follow. Listen. Listen carefully when someone is speaking. Raise your hand when you want to speak. Don't just start speaking. Cover your mouth when you sneeze or cough. Share with others. Eat politely. Properly you should eat. Wash your hands. Then keep your hands to yourself. Do not touch others. Say please and thank you. These are very good words. Take turns. Give the turns to others also. Put things away. Meet means keep the things in the proper places after using them. And help others. Those who need your help, you should help them. In our today's video, we will continue with chapter 15, adverbs that we have just started in the previous lecture. So in today's lecture, first I'll give the short revision of the previous video. Then we will solve the textbook exercises. So be ready with your notebook, pencil, eraser. So let's begin the chapter, adverbs. So in the previous video, as you know, we had started chapter 15, adverbs, solving the textual exercises. We had done the warm-up exercise, right? As you know that we have completed this warm-up exercise, let's have a look at it once again. Look at the pictures and tick the correct adverbs to complete these sentences. The first one we had done: a tortoise walks slowly. The clown laughs happily. The dog barks loudly. The girl is sleeping peacefully. Mother is scolding angrily. So the words you have used tell us more about an action. A word that tells us more about when, where, and how an action is done is called adverb. This we had studied in the previous video. Today we shall continue with exercise number 1. This is the first exercise of the chapter. So let us solve. This is the textual exercise, so you must write the answers in your notebook. Fill in the blanks with the adverbs from the box. See, the adverbs are given in the box. Let us read all the adverbs first and then read the sentences. Carefully. Bitterly. Quickly. Melodiously. Hungrily. Slowly. Now. Merrily. Immediately. Yesterday. So as you can see over here, these are the adverbs which are given. There are 10 adverbs and there are 10 blanks. As you can see, 10 adverbs are there and 10 blanks are there. Here are first 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and here are the next till number 10. The options are the same. So we will read these 10 blanks and we will write the answers in each of these blanks, selecting from the options given above. Let's read number 1. The old man walked dash. The old man walked dash. Now, as you know, the old man, he cannot walk very fast because of his old age. He cannot walk very fast. So how will he walk? What is the correct option? The old man walked slowly. So we will write that answer in the box. Let us write. So just learn the spelling also. S-L-O-W-L-Y. The old man walked slowly. Here we have used this option, right? So we will cut that option out. The old man walked slowly. After that, number 2. I met him dash. Met means to meet someone. To meet someone. Now, when you meet someone, you can tell the time. When did you meet? Today, yesterday, or did you meet 2 days back? When did you meet? So here, can you find the correct option? Here it is. Yesterday. So let us write that answer. Y-E-S-T-E-R-D-A-Y. Yesterday. I met him yesterday. So we cut out that option because that option has also been taken. I met him yesterday. It shows the time. Then we danced dash at the party. We danced dash at the party. How did we dance? When you are dancing, you are very happy, right? The person who is dancing, that person is really very happy. So how did they dance? We danced merrily. Merrily means happily. Merrily means happily. M-E-R-R-I-L-Y. Merrily. We danced merrily at the party. Let us cut the option merrily. We danced merrily at the party. Then number 4. Do your project dash without making mistakes. Do your project dash without making mistakes. So when you are doing your project, means when you are completing your fair book or doing any important work, how should you do it? You have to be very careful. Without making mistakes means very careful. See over here it is. Number 1. Let's write the spelling. C-A-R-E-F-U-L-L-Y. Carefully. So we will cut out the first option also because that we have used in the answer. Do your project carefully without making mistakes. Now let us change the page. Here is the page. So let us cut the options which we already used. We have used the options carefully, slowly, yesterday, merrily. All these options we have already used, like we have done in the previous page. Now number 5. Pinky sings dash. So when someone sings, the voice of Pinky over here is given. The voice is very sweet voice. Can you find any such word which are left? The green color options which are given, can you find any suitable word, any appropriate word for this blank? Pinky sings dash. How does she sing? She sings melodiously. Melodiously means very sweetly. A very sweet voice is called melodious voice. M-E-L-O-D-I-O-U-S-L-Y. It is a big spelling, I know that, but you should learn the spelling. M-E-L-O-D-I-O-U-S-L-Y. Melodiously means the person who has sweet voice is called melodious voice. So the option is over here. Sorry, by mistake I put it in the second, number 6, but it is the answer of number 5. Pinky sings melodiously. Then number 6. The mouse scampered away dash on seeing the cat. Scampered away means the mouse ran away, right? When the mouse will see the cat, it is obvious that mouse will run away because the cat will eat the mouse. So mouse will run away. How did he run? How will the mouse run? Will the mouse go slowly or fast? How will the mouse go? So the mouse ran quickly. Here you can write quickly. The mouse scampered away quickly. Let's write that answer. The spelling is already given. Q-U-I-C-K-L-Y. The mouse scampered away quickly on seeing the cat. Number 7. The baby cried dash when the babies, they cry very hard. So the baby cried dash. First of all, let us cut the option which we already used. This option we have used. So here the answer should be bitterly. The baby cried bitterly means very badly the baby cried a lot. The baby cried bitterly. So let's cut that option. Now we have only three options left and three blanks. Number 7. It's number 8. It is 11:30 p.m. Go to sleep dash. It is 11:30 p.m. Go to sleep dash. So go to sleep immediately. Immediately means right now. Don't waste your time because it is too late. You should not be awake so late at night. So go to sleep immediately. IMMEDIATELY. It is 11:30. Go to sleep immediately. Number 9. We have to drive dash or we will miss the train. If you will not drive fast, you will miss the train. See, this option we have used. Now only two options are left. Now or hungrily. So we cannot add hungrily over here. But now, yes, that is the correct option. We have to drive now or we will miss the train because it's already very late. If you don't reach the railway station on time, the train will go away. So we have to drive now. That shows time. So also that option we have used. Now only one option left in the options, hungrily. So read the last one. The children ate the sandwiches dash. So only one option left, hungrily. Even that we cut out now. How did the children eat? The children ate hungrily. H-U-N-G-R-I-L-Y. Hungrily. The children ate the sandwiches hungrily. So here we completed exercise number 1, where the options were given and we had to write the correct answers of the adverbs. Now we have the sentences. Let's read these sentences. He is walking slowly. The cat is eating hungrily. Peter is swinging merrily. The highlighted adverbs tell us how an action is done. Adverbs that tell us how an action is done are called adverbs of manner. So these are all adverbs of manner. Slowly, hungrily, merrily, all these are adverbs of manner because they give the answer how an action is done. See, for example, how is he walking? Slowly. How is the cat eating? Hungrily. How is the Peter swinging? Merrily. So all these give the answer for the question how, and they are called adverbs of manner. Now for the same we have exercise number 2. The adverbs have been used incorrectly in these sentences. Rewrite the sentences using correct adverbs. So here the wrong adverbs are used in the sentences. The adverbs which are used like bravely, wisely, sweetly, quickly, clearly, all these are incorrect. The wrong adverbs have been used. We have to write the correct sentences. We have to change the adverbs between the sentences. See, there are 5 sentences which are given. Adverbs which are used are wrong. We have to change the adverbs. So first of all, let us find out the adverbs. Bravely is the adverb. Wisely is the adverb. Sweetly is also the adverb. Here quickly and over here clearly. These are all the adverbs that I have underlined. So among these five sentences, the wrong adverbs we have to change and we have to put with the right sentence. I hope you understand. Now let us read the first one and correct the sentence which is given. So number one, Govind reads bravely. Govind reads bravely. So bravely is not needed. Brave means you have a lot of courage, a lot of energy, but for reading it is not needed to be brave. But when you read, you have to be very clever. You have to be very clever. So see, can you find any option? Govind reads dash. Can you find any such option? Yes, we can see this clearly. When you read, you have to be loud and clear, right? You have to read clearly. So clearly we can write instead of bravely. See, I am writing the answer. You should also write along with me. The same sentence you have to write. Govind, G-O-V-I-N-D. Govind reads clearly. C-L-E-A-R-L-Y. And we'll stop. Govind reads clearly. So what is the adverb that we have used? Clearly. That is correct. Then see, the soldiers fought wisely. Now when the soldiers are fighting, they have to be very brave. They have to be very courageous. So wisely is the wrong adverb. Bravely is the correct adverb, right? So this word we have to use over here. So let's write the answer for the same. See the answer how to write? Here I am writing the answer for number 2. The soldiers fought, F-O-U-G-H-T. The soldiers fought bravely, B-R-A-V-E-L-Y. And then we put full stop. The soldiers fought bravely. So the adverb used over here is bravely. See the first two sentences we have done. Govind reads clearly, the soldiers fought bravely. This word we have changed because adverb was wrong. Then see number 3. He ran sweetly. Now while you are running, you don't have to be sweet. But while you are running, you have to be very quick. You have to be very fast. So can you find any such word over here? See, quickly. So that word quickly you have to use instead of sweetly. See how I write the answer. He ran, then you will write quickly, because sweetly is the wrong word, but yes, quickly is the right word. So he ran quickly, not sweetly. Then see number 4. The child behaved quickly. Now the behavior cannot be quick, but yes, the behavior can be wise. So see the adverb over here in the second sentence, wisely. This wisely means very nicely, in a good manner. So the behavior can be wise. Instead of quickly, we have to use wise. So the answer, the child behaved, B-E-H-A-V-E-D. The child behaved wisely, W-I-S-E-L-Y. So here the spelling is what I have written. The child behaved wisely, and the answer is wisely. Means instead of quickly, you have to write wisely. And number 5. The bird sang clearly. Now when the bird sings, it is very sweet voice. So we have to find the adverb which is given. See here, sweetly. Yes, this word sweetly can be used instead of clearly. We should not write clearly, but we can write sweetly. So let's write the answer for the same. See, here I am writing the answer. The bird sang. Sang is the past tense of sing. The bird sang sweetly. And then we put full stop. So which word did we change? Instead of clearly, we have written the adverb sweetly. Instead of writing clearly, what did we write? Sweetly. So the correct adverb is sweetly. Don't write this one. The correct answer is this. So we completed exercise number 2 over here. You can check the answers. After that, let us read the sentences which are given. I sang yesterday. They will go for a vacation tomorrow. Sana will call you later. So here the highlighted adverbs tell us when the action happens, when the action takes place. So it is answering the question when. So adverbs that tell us when an action happens are called adverbs of time. See, the words are yesterday, tomorrow, later. All these give the answer of the question when the action happens. When. In short, you have to remember this word, when. When did I sing? Yesterday. When will they go for a vacation? Tomorrow. When will Sana call you? Later. So each and every sentence answers the question when. It is called adverb of time. So now you understood what is adverb of time. See these sentences. Come here. I searched everywhere for the money. Let us go outside and play. The highlighted adverbs tell us where the action happens. Adverbs that tell us where an action happens are called adverbs of place. See, here, everywhere, outside, these are the words which are in red color. They give us the answer of the question where. See, for example, where should I come? Here. Where did I search for the money? I searched everywhere. Where should we go and play? Outside. So each and every question answers where. That is called adverb of place. When gives the adverb of time. Where gives the adverb of place. Now, based on that, let us solve exercise number 3. Underline the adverbs and state their kinds. So, here 10 sentences are given. 10. We have to identify which one is the adverb and we have to write the kind of the adverb. I hope you remember the kind of adverb. Adverb of manner, adverb of place, adverb of time. Adverb of manner, place, time. Remember these 3 names. Let us see number 1. Let us play now. So what is the adverb over here? Now. Now is the adverb. Which kind of adverb it is? It is adverb of time. So you can write full sentence adverb of time. I am just writing in short. It is time. Because now, afterwards, all these words show us the time. Number 2. I have read this story before. So here also, before it shows time. Means once I have read this story before, in the past, it shows the time. So before is also time. So we copy the same word, adverb of time. See students, be careful. In exam you have to write adverb of time. I am just writing time because we know that we are learning the lesson of adverbs. So I am not writing the whole sentence. Number 3. I ride my bicycle fast. I ride my bicycle fast. So what is the adverb, do you know, over here? The adverb is fast. How do I ride my bicycle? Fast. So fast is manner. It shows the manner in which I ride my bicycle. You have to ask the question how. How do I ride the bicycle? Fast. So that is adverb of manner. Then number 4. My father has gone out. My father has gone out. Out is the place. Where has my father gone? If I ask the question where. Where has my father gone? So the answer is out. And which kind of adverb? It is adverb of place. Because outside, inside, they all show the place. Then see number 5. It is raining heavily. It is raining heavily. Can you find out any adverb? Heavily. Heavily is which kind of adverb? It is adverb of manner. Because we ask the question how. How is it raining? Heavily. How is it raining? heavily. Also ly is there, adverb of manner. Now let's see the next one. My donkey trotted away. My donkey trotted away. Can you find out any adverb? Away. Away is which kind of adverb? It is place, because away, near, far, all these, they show the place. So away is a place. Then next, the little children looked up. The little children looked up. Up. See, up, down, below, under, above, all these are the places. They show the place. On the bench, below the bench, upstairs, downstairs, they all show the place. So that is also adverb of place. Up and down, they show the place. Next, they helped us gleefully. They helped us gleefully. So here the adverb is gleefully. Do you know which kind of adverb it is? Just like here there is ly. So we have written manner. Same way here also ly is there. So which kind of adverb it is? Adverb of manner. M-A-N-N-E-R. Manner. It is adverb of manner. How did they help us? Gleefully. The visitors will arrive soon. The visitors will arrive soon. Here, soon is the adverb because it shows the time. If I ask the question, when will the visitors come? Visitors means the people, those who come. So when will they come? Soon. It shows the time of coming. It shows the time. So it is adverb of time. When will the visitors come? They will come soon. Rana is waiting upstairs for you. Rana is waiting upstairs for you. Here upstairs is the adverb. Which kind of adverb it is? What does it show? Time, place or manner? It is adverb of place. So we copy the same word, place. Adverb of place. Why? Upstairs means when you go, when you climb the stairs and you go up. Right? On the second floor, on the third floor, you have to climb the stairs. So upstairs, downstairs, inside, outside, they all show the place. What do they show? They show the place. So it is adverb of place. So here we complete exercise number 3. Let us see what we understood today. We solved the textual exercises. First we did the revision of warm-up. Then we completed exercise 1, selecting the adverb of manner. After that we understood adverb of manner. Then we completed exercise number 2. And then we studied adverb of time, place, and finally we completed exercise number 3. Thank you for watching the video. Complete your textbook till here. Have a nice day.